Today, we are going to be talking about the La Grande Odalisque. It was made by the French painter Jean-Auguste Dominique Ingres and is part of the Romanticism style.
It was made in 1814 and is oil on canvas. The event that is being presented is the viewer is an exotic Odalisque figure.
An Odalisque is a Harlem girl, which is typically of Turkish descent. The event that this piece is depicting is the Western idea of a harem girl.
It is a French fantasy of a harem girl that is not anatomically correct. This piece is all about sensuality and exotic nature of the Eastern world of the time.
It is also about bringing others to the status of the higher class. This piece was created to establish a personal identity.
It was commissioned by Pauline Borghese, who was Napoleon's sister. It was supposed to be given to Napoleon as a gift from her, but by the time that Ingres finished it, Napoleon was out of power.
Yes, and the patron was involved in this piece by being the model for the Odalisque.
Because she was a slut. This piece was made for the private home of Napoleon, which was her brother.
It was created for him because she wanted to show the imperialistic views of France at the time. And in this piece, there's evidence that suggests a relationship between the artist and the model. And the evidence of this is that the pose that she is in.
Yes, this suggests a relationship because the pose suggests sensuality and doesn't deal with fidelity with the piece.
Now, this piece reflects the culture and the current time that it was made in by the frivolity and the sexual tones in this piece.
This is because at the time, the upper class were becoming filled with power and wealth. This reflects the artist's lifestyle by the luxurious fabrics and accessories surrounding her.
Yes, and these fabrics are luxurious because of the color and the lacing on them, which would have taken time and effort to skillfully weave together.
The next piece we are looking at is Tamati Waka Nene, and was made in 1890.
This is also oil on canvas, and was made in the Polynesia area, and was painted by Gottfried Lindor.
The event that is being shown to us is the painting of a Maori war leader named Tamati Waka Nene. He was an important chief of the Ngati Heo people.
Yes, and he is shown wearing indigenous but also prestigious cloak and treasures associated with the people and the time. This piece was made to establish a cultural identity for the Maori people, because it was feared that their ways of life were disappearing due to British missionaries and changes to their land quickly happening in this time and place.
The patron was Henry Petridge, who had involvement in the portrait-making process, which was the reason for painting the chiefs of the Maori people. Also, he wanted to amass a collection of the people to make sure their original heritage wouldn't disappear.
Yes. Now, this piece was created as a part of a public piece and was shown to the public in 1915 as part of a collection of 62 portraits at the Auckland Art Gallery.
The reason for this was so people could see the Maori people in their indigenous activities.
Yes. Tamati Waka Nene had no relationship with the artist who was painting this, because by the time this was painted, he was already dead. This painting was done using copies of photographic portraits of Nene, which were taken years before he had died.
This piece reflects the culture of the Maori people and the time period by showing him wearing the indigenous clothing and garments of the people. This shows that the English missionaries who had arrived there hadn't completely taken over yet.
This piece reflects the artist's lifestyle by showing the chief leader, Tamati Waka Nene. This is what the patron wanted, and this is what the artist studied and came to this area to do.
Thank you.
you just feel tired, you feel weak. But when you feel weak, you feel like you want to just give up. But you gotta search within you. Try to find that inner strength and just pull that shit out of you. And get that motivation to not give up and not be a quitter. So like Holatz, I'm spilling these rats long as you feel them. Till the day that I drop, you'll never say that I'm not killing them. Cause when I am not, then I'ma stop pinning them. And I am not hip-hop, and I'm just not Eminem. Subliminal thoughts when I'ma stop spinning them. Women are caught in webs, spin them in hawk venom. Adrenaline shots, the penicillin could not.